take the admin here?
Let's take it
11.
9A, karaoke, take 4.
Thank you.
Oh. Thank you. There's nothing like being in the same room with fellow musicians and performers. The extent to which we rely on each other's physical presence is so clear when you haven't got it. And when we were able to get together for the first time, today being for some the first time since March last year, it's an incredibly overwhelming experience. Lots of people have been practicing in their own rooms, on their own, trying to imagine what the sound is like. And one violinist told me yesterday that they had completely forgotten what it was like to respond to a room and its various acoustics. But the skill of all these musicians means that we've just jumped back onto the saddle, and it feels very familiar.
I mean, hearing music, particularly hearing the B minor mass, is just absolutely supreme. It's something we've all missed so much over the last dry, arid few months with a lack of music, and hearing that joyous bounce in the music, the dance is absolutely glorious. My name's Declan Costello. I am an ear, nose and throat surgeon specialising in voice disorders, and I'm also a singer. There was a lot of negative press about singing. There had been clusters of COVID centred around choirs, and there was concern that the singing itself was maybe somehow inherently dangerous, but that wasn't very clear. It wasn't clear whether it was that or whether it was the social aspects, people hugging at the ends of rehearsals and these sorts of things. So I collaborated with aerosol researchers from Bristol University and from the Royal Brompton and with other ENT colleagues to actually quantify how much aerosol is generated by singing and whether actually, in fact, it was very much more aerosol generating than speaking or shouting.
The first, I guess, month of lockdown was quite fun in a way, and it was a nice rest. But I was booked to do Garsington in July, August, and of course that got cancelled. And then when that happened, that was when it sort of hit home that actually this was going to be lasting longer than just 2 or 3 months. And I was bumping into musicians where I live in North London, and it became clear that although everything else was opening, musicians were the only people, seemingly, who had no work and who were really actually getting more and more scared and panicked and miserable about it and lonely as well. So I decided to start a music series of my own. It began with just one concert, and it was just, the main thing was just to play some Bach.
The summer of last year, bars and pubs and restaurants were starting to open up again. They're quite noisy places and people were raising their voices in them. And at the same time, people weren't allowed to raise their voices in singing. It was locked down in this country and around the world.
People were drinking their pints and stuff outside the Italian restaurant that was just opposite this tower. And I thought, well, if those 30 or so people gathering every single night, drinking their pints of beer, can stand there in, you know, socially distanced clumps as they were, then why can't they just walk across the road and do the same thing, but with us playing to them?
And the research we did looked very closely at the amount of aerosol that was being produced, and we established that although there is more aerosol produced in singing than in loud speaking or in shouting, there wasn't a huge amount more, and actually much more important was how loudly you're singing or how loudly you're speaking, by a factor of tenfold, from the very quietest to the very loudest singing and speaking. You're producing a tenfold increase in the amount of aerosol. So that was the thing that we principally found. And it was on the back of that that singing was allowed to open up again in the summer of last year.
Obviously, with the first concert, was so exciting, so moving. And I remember the first moment of seeing all these musicians, all my friends and stuff playing together was so incredibly moving for me. I was tearful about it. And in fact, everyone was. I think it just gave people an incredible feeling of hope. And, you know, this is going to come to an end at some point. And in the meantime, we have to just pile all our love and joy into these tiny little moments we get, a bit like this B minor mass now. It's a sort of small island in a sea of not much that makes it in a way more special.
I sing regularly in a variety of different choirs, including with the Oxford Bach Soloists, and I'm really looking forward to getting back to singing properly. We're beginning to see here in the early spring of 2021 the green shoots of singing start to emerge. Hearing music today has made me realise how very much I miss it, and it's just something I can't wait to get back doing.
I feel like I have enjoyed singing these little sort of jewels, I guess, of experience so much more than I ever thought I would, or so much more than before this time. And I think from now on I will never take this job for granted.